Class 10 students of St. Michael's Academy, welcome to online physical science class. Good morning, class 10 students. Today I am starting atomic nucleus. What is radioactivity? The property for which some elements with higher atomic mass disintegrate spontaneously. Disintegrate means breaking down. Break down spontaneously in any stable elemental or compound to produce atoms of new elements and are associated with radiation of a special kind of invisible rays. This property is called radioactivity. Henry Becquerel in 1896 discovered radioactivity. Now Henry Becquerel in 1896, noticed that invisible rays are emitting spontaneously from some uranium compounds. These rays penetrate through the black paper. Madame Curie, the competent student of Becquerel, named this phenomenon of emitting invisible rays as radioactivity. Radioactive rays are rays, those are emitted from a radioactive material. Main radioactive rays are three types, alpha rays, beta rays and gamma rays. Now properties of alpha, beta and gamma rays. I have given you these points so that you can understand these things clearly. First one, alpha radiation is the name for the emission of an alpha particle, in fact an helium nuclei. Beta radiation is the emission of electrons or positrons, and gamma radiation is the term used for the emission of energetic photons. Now first, alpha rays are the positively charged particles. Alpha particle is highly active and energetic helium atom that contains two neutrons and protons. These particles have the minimum penetration power and highest ionization power. They can cause serious damage if get into the body due to their high ionization power. Now, beta rays are high energy and speed electrons. They are emitted from a radioactive material after the beta decay. They are negatively charged particles. They carry one unit negative charge. So, formula of beta ray is 0e minus 1 and formula of alpha ray is 4he2. Now, gamma rays. Gamma rays characteristics are very simple because it is electromagnetic radiation. Gamma photons have no mass and no electrical charge. See, I have used gamma photons, this photon word. That is, you know that photon particles are very highly energetic particles and they travel at the speed of light, being able to cover hundreds to thousands of meters in air before spending their energy. Here I have given one diagrammatic representation of nature of alpha, beta and gamma rays. See the first one. When alpha particle eliminates from any unknown atom like X, so its mass number A decreased by 4 and atomic number Z decreased by 2. And a new element or new atom rather you can say X dash A minus 4 Z minus 2 is formed. Now, next one, in case of beta decay, when beta particle eliminates from that unknown atom, what happens? Its mass number will never change, but its atomic number will increase by 1 because beta particle formula is 0e minus 1 or 0 beta minus 1. An alpha particle formula is 4He2 or 4α2. Now the last one, gamma particle emission. When gamma particle emission happens from that particular unknown atom, no change occurs to that particular atom because it is just a rays. Hope so you have understood the first picture. Now come to the second peak. Here I have shown that alpha particle cannot penetrate paper, plastic, concrete, steel, lead, etc. But beta particle can penetrate paper, but not plastic and any other thing. But gamma particle, as because it's a ray, photon actually, it's a cluster of proton rays, so it can penetrate paper, plastic, concrete, steel, lead, anything. What are radioactive elements? Radioactive elements are unstable isotopes that release subatomic particles or energy as they decay. Alpha decay releases two protons and two neutrons. It's potentially dangerous but can be stopped by a thin barrier. See, I have shown you three diagrams. The first one, this stone one, is uranium. The second one, that green color one, is radium. And the third one, that is circle one, that is polonium. These are all radioactive elements. See the examples. Example of natural radioactivity where uranium atom breaking down to form thorium and one helium or alpha particle releases. Next one, from thorium, if one beta particle releases, then one Pa atom will be formed. And from the last one, radium, from radium, if one alpha particle releases, then one thorium atom will be formed. In your book also, there are other examples of radioactive elements where Bi means bismuth, Th thorium, Rn radon, Po polonium, carbon potassium, V for vanadium, La for lanthanides, etc. Uranium is one of the radioactive element. Now what is uranium? Uranium is a chemical element with the symbol U, capital U, and atomic number 92. It is a silvery gray metal in the actinide series of the periodic table. You have already studied periodic table. So, you have studied lanthanides and actinide series also. So, you have understood. Next one, a uranium atom has 92 protons and 92 electrons, of which 6 are valence electrons. Why uranium is dangerous? Because uranium decays by alpha particles. External exposure to uranium is not as dangerous as exposure to other radioactive elements because the skin will block the alpha particles. Ingestion of high concentrations of uranium, however, can cause severe health effects such as cancer of the bone or liver, etc. Thorium. Thorium is a naturally occurring, slightly radioactive metal discovered in 1828 by the Swedish chemist John Jacob Berzelius, who named it after Thor, the Norse god of thunder. It is found in small amounts in most rocks and soils, where it is about 3 times more abundant than uranium. Now, why thorium is dangerous? Thorium is radioactive and can be stored in bones. Because of these facts, it has the ability to cause bone cancer many years after the exposure has taken place. Breathing in massive amounts of thorium may be lethal. People will often die of metal poisoning when massive exposure takes place. Prove that radioactivity is a nuclear phenomenon. Because expulsion of an alpha particle produces a new nucleus of an atom with atomic number less by 2 units and mass number less by 4 units than the original atomic nucleus, because the formula of atomic particle is 4He2. That's why. Now, on the other hand, expansion of a beta particle, the atomic number is increased by 1 unit than that of the original nucleus. There is no change of mass number, because the formula of beta particle is 0E-1. Now, due to emission of radioactive rays, there is a change of structure of the nucleus of the radioactive element, and new elements are formed. So, it is proved that radioactivity is a nuclear phenomenon. See the example. 218 PO is polonium 84. One is mass number, another one is atomic number. Forming 214 PB, that is lead, with 82 atomic number, plus 4He2, that is alpha particle. That means for emission of one alpha particle from one polonium, one lead particle is formed. But its mass number decreases by 4 and atomic number decreases by 2. In this slide, I have shown you the uses of radioactivity. Please read the table and picture carefully. Here, carbon 14, phosphorus 32, phosphorus 33, that means that particular isotope. Uses also written. And beneficial uses of radioactivity in the diagrammatic picture also I have given. But one thing you should remember, along with this, you have to read the examples from your book also. Because in your book also there are some important isotopes and their uses given. Thank you. For any queries or doubts, please email me at sudeshna1.sma@outlook.com.